So in this example, I'm showing you a test that passed. Why am I showing you a test that passed? Well, the client contacted us and said, hey, my 1000BASE-T switch keeps on backing down to 100BASE-T. And so what we did is we did a Class EA channel test because this was a Class EA cabling system. And we chose channel because we're measuring everything, patch cords, the whole shooting match from end to end. And when we did that EA test, which is similar to Category 6A, it's a 500 megahertz test, we see everything passed with good margin. Now, opinions vary on what good margin is, but just so you know, in this game, 6 dB is a factor of 2. So when I see my return loss and my crosstalk better than 6 dB above what the standard requires, I'm twice what the standard requires. So there's no question as to how good this cabling system is. So it must be an application issue, right? Not so fast. When a manufacturer claims compliance on their cabling system, it actually also includes some other measurements which are not done in the field. And one of these is called TCL, transverse conversion loss. This is a balance measurement. Now, the reason why it's not a field test is because up until this instrument was launched, it was not thought possible to be able to do that measurement in the field. The other thing to note is that as far as the TCL measurement is concerned, at this time of writing this video, there are only limits for the channel, not for the permanent link. I hope that would change sometime in the future. So everything here passes. Let's redo this test again, but now include that additional TCL measurement, which is required in the laboratory, but not required in the field. I've got it stored on my instrument here. So let me go back up. So this is exactly the same link, same cords, same everything, but now we've done this plus all tests. This is our new test limit, which includes all the measurements that this tester can do, including resistance and balance. And we see that it fails. Now, if I go to the bottom of my list, I see some new measurements here. And the one that I'm going to focus on, of course, is the one that failed, TCL, with a margin of minus 4.3 dB. Indeed, if I go and look at that and tap pair here, it will automatically go to that worst performing pair. And I do pinch and zoom. Here's my limit line, and I can clearly see that the TCL performance is dropped below the limit line. So what do we learn from this? You can have great confidence in doing a certification test, but there may be a rare occasion where you have poor balance in the cable. So consider TCL at this stage as a troubleshooting tool. You can't use it as a certification tool because there are no limits for the permanent link. But keep that in mind as a potential future test.